The 0-1. Popped up. Center fielder draws a beat on it. He holds it in. J.J. Woolwine makes the third and final out, and Fishers has won a state championship in high school baseball in their first appearance at Victory Field.
Pause. That's me, if you're wondering. So you think, how'd I get in this situation? Well, let me tell you. It all started in the summer of 17.
You know, that was not an easy catch by J.J. Woolwine out there, because Greg Yoho was running like crazy and tracked that ball down in short center field and barely eluded a collision.
Out here in the fields, I fought for my meals. I get my back into my living. I don't need to fight to prove I'm right. I don't need to be forgiven. Yeah, 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 yeah.
We definitely should have won that game. We were the better team.
They'll be going home early at the hands of Zionsville with a final score 4-3.
And thus, the rebuilding started.
You can run on for a long time.
From day one, our goal was stay.
Run on for a long time. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Sooner or later,
we all knew that we had the team to do it. The team was completely bought in. Everyone wanted the same goal. On top of that, like even the bench guys who weren't playing, they wanted it for us. We all knew how to get there. We should have been the ones that won that game and gone on. Definitely a chip on our shoulder.
The guys know what it takes. Some of the older guys know what it takes.
There's nobody like, oh, I'm not playing, I'm not going to be here anymore. Like, everyone was bought into the team, and everyone did their job, and everyone worked together with each other. There was a point in the season where everyone was hitting. We were shutting out teams, and like, we just looked unstoppable.
When he said, John, go do my will, go tell that long-tongued liar.
Home run!
This Fishers Tigers team has been on a total steamroll this year, completely demolishing the competition through this red-hot streak. It seems as though no one can stop them.
You can run on. Yeah, I completely agree, Joey. This team is nearly unbeatable. I almost wonder how they even lost in the regionals last year.
So first game of regionals, we got Zionsville, and going into the game, everyone knew the stakes, everyone knew what happened last year. Our whole team had a chip on their shoulder, and Zionsville pretty much returned their whole lineup. So, and we were confident though, we came in because we swept them in the series to win conference that year too. But you couldn't help but think in the back of your mind that it's like they're almost due to beat us. And both teams are doing well. Just like the previous year, 2017, it's a close game the whole time. And everyone on our team is doing good. Everyone's hitting well. But so is everyone on Zionsville. You know, we had the lead. And we're going. Unbelievable pitcher. And we ended up winning the game. It was awesome. So yeah, that was awesome.
And just like that, the Tigers' season comes to an end. A devastating loss for a Fishers team that many thought had a chance at state this year.
You could probably ask anyone. We didn't even play our best baseball postseason. The coaches just know that there's a limit that we can go to.
For me, it was just seeing the guys connect, their camaraderie, how much they love one another.
Called strike one.
They didn't care who got the credit.
Our umpire has a tendency, his style is to keep us all on the edge of our seats until he makes his call.
They wanted to win for each other. They found ways to pick each other up and someone to do something well.
It's not been popular at all.
Exciting. A lot of relief, a lot of hard work. Just kind of that sense of relief almost, all the hard work finally coming to pay off for what the world can see, what the state can see.
You know, that was not
an easy
catch by J.J. Woolrine
to get that reward for the guys.
Was running like crazy to track that ball down in short center field.
Years of putting in hard work and building the program and guys working hard.
Tremendous team effort from the Fishers Tigers tonight.
A lot of people going to be happy for Matthew Cherry. I mean, 12 years is a long time. 204. 71-1. Tournament victories over North Central and Noblesville. They beat Zionsville. Let's go down to field level. Jeremiah Johnson.
So much emotion on the field here at Victory Field. Matthew, nerve-wracking final couple of innings. What were you thinking in the dugout, and what was the message of your pitcher there in the seventh?
We were thinking love wins. Our guys love one another. They compete for one another. They find a way to win. Grant's been great all season, just pounding the zone. He's our best strikeout guy, so we wanted to stay with him.
When the out was made and you and your coaches got together, did you think back to taking this job 12 years ago and the journey you've been on?
Yeah, super excited. Happy for these guys. They worked their tails off. Happy for our coaching staff. And happy for this group. These fans are amazing.
It's been a little bit of a progression. You got the sectional last year. You had the regional heartbreak. You told me about the victory challenges in the morning and the off-season workouts. This has pretty much been 12 months from when you were eliminated to get to this point where the work has been continuing.
Yeah, this group, they lost last year. They had a bad taste in their mouth with Zionsville in the regional. And they committed to it. They love one another. I just love wins. They love one another. And they bought me butts off.
Brotherhood was the motto all season. Congratulations.
Thank you.
He's trying to answer the questions, but I think he's in a state of shock. That's great stuff, JJ, for sure. You're watching the Indiana Baseball State Championships on the IHSAA Champions Network.
And that's how it ended. A perfect conclusion to a spectacular season.